Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Microsoft Teams has a great feature now with search. They've really improved it. Let's take a look at it right now. So I have Teams running. Search is at the top. That's also called the command bar. You can get there on the keyboard with Control and the letter E. I'm just going to click here with my mouse. I'm going to type in a search term. I am making this up. I'm going to put it in Las Vegas and press Enter. When search appears, over on the left-hand side, we've got all messages, people, and files. So they have broken it up for us. And since I'm on all, I see three messages. I happen to have three files. I actually have more messages and I have more files. And then people, no one is called Las Vegas. If I go to messages, this is really cool. This is where it gets really good. In Teams, we have chats, one-on-one and group, but we also have channel conversations. So if you hit this drop-down for type, you got chat and you got channel. Before I select one of those, notice on messages, top results, conversation here with Christian, conversation here, human resources general. Human resources is a team, general is the channel. Same thing down below here, I've got conversations with Carol. So this human resources general, if I click here and say, I want to see channel messages, all the one-on-one and group chats disappear and I'm only looking at channel messages. And actually have another one for website and videos, a team, public speaking events is a channel. Let's go the other way real quick, change it to just chat. And now I'm looking at just chat. Another cool feature you can do from here is if you're in here, here's my conversation with Carol. I can go to the message. A go to message appears when you mouse over that message. Click go to message and you jump there. There is the message with Las Vegas. To get back up in the very top left, the arrow to the left takes me back to where I was. So I don't have to redo the chat. I'm going to clear out the chat part. Still on messages, I can pick from a team and a channel. I can do from and type in someone's name. Very cool. I've got a date range here. That's one item I was missing before this update is like, okay, I know this happened either last month or this month or yesterday or something. I even can select a range down below. If I hit this month, by the way, one is correct because I was testing this. Today is January 2nd, 2022, and that is the only one I've got this month. Perfect. At mentions, here we go, has attachments. Those are messages with attachments. Just to prove it, click on this one for Las Vegas. Go to message. It's got a couple files in it. There we go. Turn that off. Also have this option over here to clear all. People, no one is called Las Vegas. I'm going to skip that one just to show you though there's people. But here we go, files. I've got a PowerPoint, I've got a Word, I've got an Excel. I even have a CSV file. There's no icon for CSV, but I still don't care. Cool that it's showing it. If you select one of these files, open file. Now, if you recall, I did a video 2 or 3 weeks ago on Teams about where files are stored. Just remember, chats, your files are stored in OneDrive, but for team channels, your files are stored in SharePoint. So if I come over here, Department Accounting AP, that's a team and a channel, open file, I'm hoping it opens up SharePoint, and it does, and there's that file right there. Cool. If you have, I think that's it. So I don't want to do an abrupt ending, but I believe that covered it all right there. And you can do your files again by date, and you can do your files by file type, which I have showing you right here. You can even pull and go and find a team. Anyway, greatly improved search feature. Let me know if you like this. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.